Hi guys, I'm back from the holidays. Had some real long Christmas holidays and I'm back with videos now. And we'll just warm up again with some super simple white weenie deck that I created yesterday from scratch. I know white weenie in 2020, but I really like simple decks, and with the addition of new cards over the course of Magic the Gathering, it's interesting to go back to basically like back deck archetypes. Or do we keep this? I think we keep this. Go back to deck archetypes and just see how they work with some new cards. So yeah, created this deck. And I just want to go climb through the ladder a bit, because I hadn't really found time to play a lot of Magic, so we're back in Silver rank now, and I want to climb up and get myself some ladder points. Yeah, really excited. So next week, Aetheris Beyond Death is going to be released to MTG Arena. I'm sure you've already been following the spoiler season. Some really exciting stuff coming up, and I actually plan to do a card review for Aetheris Beyond Death, and go through all the cards, rate them, speculate a bit which cards are going to be impactful, which will not be impactful, and I'm really curious how this will go. This is going to be my first card review, and of course after review, or soon after the review, the expansion is actually going to come out. By the way, I think we actually generated Loxodon here. Yep, expansion is going to come out, and then we have so much new content, so much new stuff to try out, and I'm really looking forward to that. Okay, so we have a Dracozef problem here. Alright, he's got a... Yeah. So what we need here is Prison Realm. What do we do here? We can get rid of this. Can we just block this? I mean, he gets the psych, right? I think we just get rid of this. Yeah, so what we would need here is... Oh, cancel. But this is a 4 agenda target feeder chips to other targets. Yeah. Nah. Actually, I think the opponent got us, so pretty unsatisfying start here for the video, I've gotta admit. But I was already thinking about putting another Prison Realm into the deck, a fourth one, because so far we only got three. So you know what, let's do that. Let's add another Prison Realm, and then what do we cut here? Maybe we cut one Icon of Ancestry. I think that seems fine. Cut an icon and just go back into the ladder. So yeah, new expansion coming up next week. I think at the moment today, so it's January 7th as I'm recording this, there are still probably around 70 to 80 cards left to be spoiled. So and the whole set has about 254 cards, if I remember correctly. So there is still a whole third of the expansion to be revealed. And so I'm really curious what is going to be revealed in the next days. I'm especially curious about the planeswalkers because, let me think, I think so far I've seen 5 planeswalkers that were revealed, something like that. And yeah, also of course I'm excited about the new mechanics, so how will they... Oh, this is actually amazing. So we can go raise the alarm, go ask the marshal, and then go venerate this Loxodon. It's basically like the dream opener we have here, together with an unbreakable formation. And yeah, I hope he doesn't have like Cry of the Carnarium. Okay, so he doesn't have the mana to cast it. That's good. Well, Puna doesn't do anything. Okay, so if we unbreakable formation, he can block a maximum of 8 and we get in for 12 damage. So we can do that, or we can just... alternatively, we can also venerate Loxodon again. And then be sure to kill him next turn, right? Let's do that. Do it like this. And... now here's the thing. There is this this new card, this witches something, blah blah blah, that gives all creatures of a certain type -3/-3, right? So I think, I mean, we don't really care about indestructible next turn, right? So I think the correct thing to do is actual just cast the unbreakable formation here. And this puts all these creatures out of range of the removal. Oh nice, our opponent has actually purchased a new pet here. I think that was the correct play. Because next turn we just attack with everything and you won't really be able to kill something. Okay, sure. Get rid of a token. That's still good for us. And yeah, that's just game. Yeah. Now this is what the deck is supposed to do. And just get in the opponent's face very quickly with Venerate Loxodons and the... what's it called? Like the instant spell we had that puts +++ colors on all creatures. Like that thing. You know what I mean. And that's the way to just quickly win games. I haven't been really playing Magic during the holidays because I stayed in my parents' place, so I don't have any way of playing Magic there. And sometimes it's really good to have a break. But now I'm excited to go back. I just, you know, want to warm up with a simple white weenie deck. Get back into shape, and then when the expansion hits next, when the expansion is next week, we're going to be prepared for some awesome new stuff. So what I'm looking forward to the most is, of course, the... like the enchantment mechanic, constellation, or like the general enchantment theme of the expansion. And then also the escape mechanic. I think that's going to be really cool. My opponent probably has a counter spell here, yeah. That's fine. Absolutely fine. So what we do here, we first grab a plains. And then... put two Lorwyn forces on the battlefield. So the way this deck works is pretty simple. You build a pretty huge board pretty fast. I actually want to attack first here and see if he has Yeah, that's really fine actually. Because now we can play the Gideon without danger of it being countered. So the way this deck works is you build a wide board very fast. You have stuff like Gideon, which just helps you put on a lot of pressure. And then once you have a wide board, you can buff it with Venerated Loxodons, for example. And then really finish out either with Bond of Discipline, which makes it so that it taps all the creatures your opponents control, which is the important part here. So this means you can just really push through with all your creatures. There's one way to end the game, the other one is the spell I shown you in the last game. I just forget what it was, but which gives all your creatures indestructible, vigilance and +1/+1 counters. Alright, so our opponent has a blast zone, which means he can destroy all of our 1/1s, which is annoying. So what are we doing here? Pretty sure if I cast Gideon, he's going to counter it. So let's attack first. Wait, don't remember, do tokens have a converted mana cost of 1 or 0? I think it's 0, right? I think it's 0. I think we still put down Sunhound Stalwart. He can blow up all of our... Okay, that's fine. He can blow up all of the Lauren forces with the Blast Zone, which he probably is going to do now. Yeah. But hopefully this enables us to cast the Gideon here. Oh really, he's got another... damn it. Okay. Good thing is our opponent is pretty much out of cards. He's got a Brazen Borrower that he can cast and some other card. That's a good thing, and I think we'll go ahead and try to cast Funeral of Glory and make 2 tokens. Really? Wow. Okay. So our opponent is pretty much top decking, just as we are. Now if this is a counter spell... Really? Oh, it's an opt. Okay, no counter spell. However, he can flash in his Brazen Borrower, which will put our Gideon at 2 when he attacks. Oh shit. Okay, so our Gideon is gone. This is really bad. This is straight up bad. Okay, we've got 5 mana. 5 mana is always the threshold where we can start pumping out 1/1s with our Castle Arden Veil. Just a nice added benefit. So we have 4 Castle Arden Veils in the deck. And also 2... What's it called? I'm gonna turn this way. 2... Citizen something? No. So what we're trying to do here, we're going to try to make him counter the Raise the Alarm, so we can play the Icon of Ancestry. Okay. And now hopefully he doesn't have another counter spell. Okay, so... I actually wonder, are all my... But Wait, all my creatures are also humans. So it's actually better to call humans instead of soldier. Never thought about that. So that our little human here can also do some work. And we won't block, so we just attack here. Okay. There is a prison realm. Yeah, I mean, to get rid of the Brineborn cutthroat. There is a stalwart. The thing is, we need to find an answer to the Brazen Borrower somehow. So we need another prison realm, actually. Yeah. What I'm really looking forward to is so new expansion. There is Elspeth Sun's Nemesis, I think it's called, and which is a 4-mana planeswalker. Yeah, it's this game. So it's a 4-mana planeswalker, which a +1 allows you to buff two creatures you choose with +2/+1. Actually, we can just show it off right here. Just go to store, right, and you can see it here. Yeah, so I'm sorry, it's not a +1, it's -1. So 4-mana, 5 loyalty planeswalker, which is already pretty solid. So -1, 2 of your creatures get +2/+1. For -2, you can create 2 human creature tokens, human soldier creature tokens. And -3, you gain 5. I think it's not irrelevant. However, she has escape 6. Exile for all the cards from your graveyard. So we want to try Elspeth as soon as the expansion comes out in this very white weenie deck. Because in matchups where you are against a control deck, this is enables you to generate continuous pressure. Because with the escape mechanic, if Elspeth is in the graveyard, you can just bring her back and start making soldier tokens again. So I'm really looking forward to playing this card, and I'm curious how this will plan out. So yeah. Oh, this is a great starting hand, actually. Can go turn 1 Marshall, turn 2... turn 2 probably Flower into Lauren Enforcer. So that on turn 3 we can actually cast Urgideon. Guaranteed. Okay, now we can actually just... I wonder, I think we should go... with the Lawrun and Forza first. So, now that we have 3 mana guaranteed, we can just play both Marshals next turn and still be sure that we hit our Gideon here next turn. Yay, card draw! So. So initially, or originally in this deck, I had 2 kinds of 1-drops. One is the Hazardous Marshal, which I still have 4 of in the deck. And the other one was Hunted Witness, which is the 1-mana 1-1 that... what do we get rid of? What do I get rid of? I think Lauren Forza. So, Hunted Witness is the 1-mana 1-1 that gives you a soldier creature token with lifelink when it dies. And while that is good, I like the Lorwyn Enforcer more for 2 reasons. First, the activated ability allows you to just pass by huge creatures that you can't deal with, Another thing is, it's also a human soldier creature type, so it synergizes well with Icon of Ancestry. Okay, so... if you play Gideon, he's going to be at 5 loyalty. And if our opponent swings in, we probably won't block. So... he might die then to a... shock, but I think we just going to risk that. One attack here.
Prepare for battle.
Oh, Prison Realm is really good. And yeah, we also have a free Finale of Glories in deck. I just love this card. It's a super efficient way to make a white board with a very good. Very good mana to stat how would you call it ratio. So like the breakpoint is 4 mana, right? For 4 mana you get 2/2, so you get for 4 mana you get 4/4 in stats. As soon as you have 5 mana, for 5 mana you get 3/2, so for 5 mana you get 3 tokens and 6/6 in stats. And then the more mana you add, the more efficient it becomes. So at 6 mana you get 4/2, so you get 8 instas and so on. Oh, actually we have... so what we're gonna do, Dreadhorde Butcher's attacking phase. And we're not gonna block anything because we're going to get rid of the Dreadhorde Butcher with Prison Realm. It's absolutely fine. Use Prison Realm here. Get rid of the Butcher. We don't want another land. On the other hand... no, we actually don't want another land because we just have a flower in hand. And just grab a land like this. And now we make one of our marshals indestructible.
I will lend you my strength.
And attack with everything, just create 2 more soldiers here. Alright, cool. That's cool. Yeah, as you can see, we have more than enough lands here. If he goes ahead and attacks my Gideon, I'm actually going to block here. Just to get rid of some of his creatures, because we're going to be able to refill our board with a lot of 2/2 tokens. And then we should be in a good spot, actually. Okay, so this is interesting. For example, the soldiers of Finale of Glory are only soldiers. They are not humans. And I wonder the soldiers of Raise the Alarm are, I guess... soldiers of Raise the Alarm are, I guess, also only soldiers. So, yeah, and on average, it's actually better to have Icon of Ancestry choose the soldier creature type instead of the human creature type. What are you gonna do? Okay. So, good news is we still have our Gideon. And I think since we just do another Finale of Glory, what we're going to do is give our good old Hester Marshall indestructible. And if that casts Finale of Glory. Wait, actually, we don't want this to attack, right? Yeah, so now we just make a bunch of tokens that is free. Whoops. And the next turn we finish out the game with Bond of Discipline. Bond of Discipline, I've actually never seen anyone use it. Maybe once, but I think it's a pretty underrated card because in like aggressive decks like this, it's just a great finisher. You have a white board, your opponent has creatures that he could block with. Then you just play the Bond, your opponent can block. You hopefully finish out the game, and even if you don't, you did a lot of damage and all the creatures had lifelink. So you really put yourself in a winning position with Bond of Discipline. Now I just realize we have 7 power on board, right? So actually we need to block here because this gives us 4 power on the board. Yeah, that was the correct play because now we have 5, 7, we have 9 damage on board. Now we can actually finish out the game. Yeah. Whatever, indestructible.
I believe in you, friend.
See, that's how you finish out the game. And your opponent can't know actually, because nobody uses this card, and it comes out of nowhere. Yay. Let's open some pack. Of course, as soon as the new expansion comes out, I'm going to be open. And I'm going to do a pack opening video. And I plan to have like, to open like 150 packs. So I've got 50 packs from the pre-order, about 50 packs worth in gold, which I can open, and then I'll probably purchase another 50 and then just be set for a new expansion. So just got interrupted by my neighbor. Yeah. So where was I? Do we keep this hand? We go first. If we don't find a third land, I don't think we keep this. I think this is actually kind of better because at least if we get to cast Raise the Alarm and Sunholm Stalwart, then we can also cast Luxon. Actually, let's just pass the turn, and I want to kill off his Gutter Bones with the Raise the Alarm. So, Regresia to your hand. Combat trick, yeah. Bam. Give me a land. It's not a land. Actually, with this deck, probably I should be less aggressive about blocking or getting rid of the opponent's creatures with my own creatures, because we are the aggressive deck, so we don't care so much about our own life total, right? We just want to damage our opponent as much as we can. Okay, so we cast the Sunholm Stalwart. Laroon Enforcer in the next turn. So we can attack with both. This is going to become a 2-2. So then do we want to do we want to risk losing this token? I think we can, just because we have the Finale of Glory in hand, which means that we'll be able to refill our board. Okay, so now we still have got three creatures on board, which is fine. Okay. So we can actually make two tokens, go all in basically. Yeah, let's do this. Make two tokens and then we use all of them to convoke the Venerated Loxodon. That's fine. So if our opponent chooses to... You want to attack with the knight. Now what I wonder here is... If I attack with everything, right? Mentor means... Put a plus one on the ground target attacking creature with lesser power. Will I get both triggers on Lauren Forcer? I'm not sure, let's test it. Yeah, no, it doesn't work. That would be a bit too good. Yeah, so he can kill one here with his Death Touchy boy. If he chooses to, I think he does. What you doing, bro? Yeah. Cast Lauren Forcer definitely here. That's GG, right? Yeah. Yes. So I should be able to get 3,000 more gold until the next expansion starts, and then I'll have enough gold for 50 packs. I think once you really get into Magic Arena and have accumulated like enough cards that you're very free to play anything you want. I think we keep this. After that, the way you go about every new expansion is basically you always get the pre-order, which is like 50 packs for 50 euros, right? Or $50, depending on where you live. And then always in between expansions, I think you can, like, depending on what kind of a regular player you are, you can. Wait, do we have to play Loxodon? I think so. Yeah. Depending on how regularly you play and how regularly you collect gold. You can probably earn around 50 to 70,000 gold in between a new expansion. And so if you just get the pre-order, which is very money efficient, right? 50 packs for 50 euro, $50 or whatever. And get the free packs from your gold that you earned in between the expansions. you will always have between 100 to 120 packs for every new expansion, and I think 100 to 120 packs for 50 euro every expansion is a very good number to be able to play a lot of differently styled decks, right? Okay, so we've got an annoying Sedge Scorpion. What we're going to do is play Finale of Glory for 2 tokens, and then next turn can actually attack with this. Next turn, finish out the game with Unbreakable Formation. That's how we'll play this deck. Very simple, very straightforward. Build a white board of small creatures, pump them up, and then go for a huge swing to end the game. What this actually works is Death Touch, and that creature is damage. I mean, that is actually not obvious to me. Although it says the creature deals damage. So yeah, you could argue. Let's not forget from the last games, Mobile District has actually Summoning Sickness. So if we pump this up, pump all up with Unbreak Formation, it's gonna block 5 and we'll do 9 damage. Is this going to be a 6? I think we do this. Yeah. Let's go. Remember, all our creatures are indestructible and vigilance, none of them can die. So I suppose he's gonna block the Loxodon. And yeah. And we'll proceed to do 9 damage. Actually, I've seen this deck. This is the second time I see this deck, which is like, it seems to be consisting of Season of Growth combined with the usual targeting or pumping skills on your creatures, and then on top of that, all creatures in your deck have Death Touch. Yeah, I've seen this exact deck already, so I've just encountered this deck. As I said, I didn't play Magic for the whole holidays. I'm not sure if this is like a what? He didn't block. Not sure if this is like a new meta deck, but yeah. Yeah, this is the exact deck that I saw. Can remove all your opponent's creatures with things like Thresh, and in the process just draw a bunch of cards. Now if he plays a bigger creature here, we are going to tap it. A bigger creature meaning a creature with CMC 2 or greater. Now so far we still have Lethal on board. And we actually have just Lethal, right? Because we do this, get an extra 3/3 on board. Yeah. Yes! That's what I'm talking about. Probably 4 mobilized districts in the deck would definitely be playable. Yeah. We go second. So since we go second, I think we can keep this hand and play a bit of a slower game. You know, just play Lauren Enforcer, probably skip a turn. And yeah, this is going to get shocked probably. And then playing the Icon of Ancestry. So Icon fits really well in this deck because basically all our creatures are soldier creatures except for the Venerated Loxodon. Speaking of which. And so this is a nice way of pumping up our creatures, and also it's a kind of card draw because this deck has no card draw. Oh shit, he's getting the best cards. And yeah. I think we are getting rid of the robber, which is very annoying. Definitely. Unbreakable Formation, actually not. What we need, we desperately need creatures right now. So when the new expansion comes out, and I'm going to be playing this deck definitely again, I want to try Elspeth in this deck, and also what I want to replace Prison Realm with is there is a new white enchantment, costs 3 mana, you don't get to scry, but you get to remove any non-land permanent of your opponent. So this new enchantment is not restricted to creatures or planeswalkers, and I think you're very happy to trade a scry effect against removing any type of non-land permanent that your opponent has. Let's play the Marshal here and play the Icon. And we are under a lot of pressure. Mostly because of the Summon Stalwart, actually. But let's see if we can make something happen here. Oh, Chandra's really bad.
I'm happy as a Hellion to start some fire. Go get him, buddies.
Yeah, this deck is really bad, probably if you go second. Probably best way to go here is do like this. Thus having a 4/4 blocker on the board, and maybe we can come back like this. This being a 3/3 also helps a lot instead of being a 2/2 because it's out of shock range. That's game, right? Yeah. Yeah, that's game. Nothing we can do here. We can block our own dude. But that's about it. Alright. I don't think there is actually much that we can change about this deck. Fine as it is. It's basically like Red Arrow, right? You have a over 50% win rate, which lets you climb the ladder, and you win fast or lose fast. So this is a nice way of just climb the ladder fast. And that's what I'm in the mood for today. I'm not like in the mood for experimenting or anything. I just wanna, you know, play some Magic and win some games. We go first, so I'm confident to accept this hand, although we can't play anything turn one. Actually, let's play the Son of the Stalwart. Now, what would be an obvious addition to this deck is, of course, a Tithe Taker. Right, another 2-drop, which is very good, but I just didn't have it, and I didn't want to use my rare cards for it, and I think that Sun of Stalwart is a very good replacement for that. Okay, so far this looks good. We have Flower Flourish for additional lands. Okay, there's a Threshing Brontodon. A Threshing Brontopal. So what we do here is we flower, we get another land. We play the land, we play the Raise the Alarm, and then we just convoke everything. I actually want to convoke the Sun Home Stalwart because he can mentor the other tokens. So this is one of those dream starts. The nut straw here would be either Bond of Discipline or take this trade every day. I forgot. Okay, we've got 12 damage on board. We can get another 3, which is 15. Do attack here with the Mobilized District. I think so. We can still make 2 tokens next turn. Let's go. Tree is going to want to block one of these 3. Right? So I think it's better if I mentor the 1-1 to maximize the damage input. And we get another soldier. Yeah. Damn, in your face. Okay, our opponent got 5 life left. Mr. Benenacha power. And yeah, that's just game, right? Yes! As I said, win fast. Win fast and simple, and climb the ladder. I wonder if you play non-stop with this deck, if you could get to Mythic rank. I mean, I don't know at the moment how the meta is at the, let's say, all the ranks from Diamond forward. Whether this deck has any chance, but it's probably too much board removal at that stage of the ladder. And yeah. Keep this hand because we can go turn 1 Huster Marshal, turn 2 Stalwart, turn 3 Venerated Loxodon. And then whatever we get in terms of lands. Oh, nice. Whatever we get in terms of land, we can pump into Finale of Glory. Castle Ardenvale. A gate deck. So he's getting Gates Ablaze. Okay, can Gates Ablaze, Gatebreaker Ram. Okay, ideal here would be... It's just a deck with the Loxodon. Now I wonder if we should cast the Finale of Glory. I actually don't think so, because at the moment... we don't have any other plays in hand. So I want this to count as much as possible. Okay, Guild Summit. Cascade Breaker Ram is so ridiculous. If he attacks, I'm... yeah. Still a lot of lands. I don't like that. So I mean... I got 5 mana, we can make 3 2/2s. If we attack, he's gonna block 4. And we do 5 damage, which will put him at 13. And then... next turn we'll have... 5. Sorry, we'll have 11 damage on board, of which he can block 3. Means he's gonna be at 5. I think we actually have to go here. We can't wait. Make 3 tokens, and then we have to hope. We need to hope to. Let's just attack here. We have to attack, and then we need to hope that we get some. You know, a bond of discipline or anything, something like that. And we need to hope that he doesn't have a bot remove right now. Speaking of which, actually for some time I had the Wanderer in the deck, which is the Planeswalker from War of the Spark. And that prevents non-combat damage to your creatures, so this helps against board removal such as Gets the Blaze. But I found it to be too clunky for this deck. Make a 1/1 token. Yeah, Unbreakable Formation. I would have needed you a bit earlier, but yeah, it's not gonna happen. As I said, win fast, lose fast with this deck. And all I want to show you is that this is a very simple, very fun deck. And probably in almost every expansion you can make, or in every standard meta you can make a white weenie deck and make it somehow work that it has an over 50% win rate. I mean, if we get a third land, this is good. So we just believe. We believe here. Let's play the Enforcer first, to have the activate ability ready. This ability, the ability of Hustle Marshal won't be ready anyway. Yeah, see? We believed and it worked. No attacks. Next turn we have actually a number of options. We can go Venerated Loxodon. We can go Gideon. We can go Prison Realm. I think the best thing to do is probably raise the alarm Loxodon. Yeah. Let's go. Yes, yes. Now we're in a good spot. Oh, I'm so happy we didn't use the Prison Realm. Now I can just get rid of the Regisaur. And before that, we get another land, so we don't miss our land drop. Man, these two flower flourishes are really doing work in this deck. Now... I actually can't tap this. I mean, I can tap it and keep my Prison Realm. Huh. I mean, I could tap it, but then I don't really get to use my mana, that's the problem. I think it's still best to go with the Prison Realm, and if anything scary comes up next turn, we can still... Oh yeah, I think we keep this. Let's still tap what's going to come. Let's get a free soldier token. Okay. And we're in a great spot here, actually. Another knight. So, the most amount of damage that he's going to block is 2 and 4, 6. And we have 2, 3, 5, 7 damage on board. It's a bit unfortunate. I wonder, should we go Loxodon or Gideon? I think Gideon actually, because we can make this guy indestructible.
Let me lead the charge into darkness.
Right, we make this guy indestructible. So he takes more damage if he doesn't block this.
Your light will cleave the darkness.
Go. Arguably, maybe I could have held two tokens back, so then we would have been able to cast an Loxodon, but... Yeah, so opponent is at one. Yeah! Win fast, lose fast. Let's open another pack. Guild of Ravnica. Narcomuba. Narcomuba might find some play in a new expansion with all these escape mechanics. I mean, there's going to be decks who mill themselves, right? And Narcomuba is a 3-1-1 flyer. I don't know, we'll see. Yeah, we definitely can't keep this, but we can keep this. Because we go first. And we just need another land. We can hope. We'll hope for another land again. We believe. We still hope. We can still get it. Oh yeah. Always works. Yeah, we play the icon here for mana efficiency. Soldier. Also, awesome animation. Okay, and now... if we get another land, we play the... We didn't, but hey, we get a Gideon. Hell yeah. I don't know, let's get... Is there any flasher for free? I don't think so. Let's get a Vigilance guy. This is going great. got a Gideon, we've got an Icon, we've got a Son of Stalwart. Now a Planeswalker I wanted to make work for so long, but I just can't make it work. It's the other Gideon, the 6 mana Gideon, which has as a passive ability that whenever I think any non-Gideon creatures attack, something like that, you put a +1/+1 counter on all those creatures. It's obviously great, but it's just 6 mana, it's too slow for decks such as these. Now let's go Vigilance again. Yeah, let's go. Okay, we still got a Raise Alarm in hand. What is that? Huh. Yeah. Okay, what do you have, boy? You have a Dotholzimir. Dotholzimir could save his ass temporarily. And if he misses it, Outlaw's Merriment. Actually, that's a nice combo. Escape to the Wilds together with 5 Invention. Get to draw 5 cards, so 5. There's an Infamizer Reborn, okay. There's a Time Wipe. Okay, we know that. Now the following, our creatures are getting busted next turn, but I think we won, right? Yeah, we won. Yes! Look at this, man! Fires of Invention, your ass. Can't keep this. I think we keep this and get rid of the Bond of Discipline. Right. You know what? Let's play Immobilized District. Healer's Hawk. Also, arguably, a very nice one drop. But it's not a human, it's not a soldier, so this doesn't fit into our deck. Oh, look, it's a Flyers deck. Haven't seen that in a while. It was real popular, obviously, with M20. We just attack here. I don't want to play the finale because it's our only real play right now, and I at least want to get 2 tokens out of it. And we're really just in a race right now with our opponent. He's got a mono white Flyers. Whoa, that's the nuts opening for him. Okay, I mean, it's impossible for us to beat such an opening. Absolutely impossible. yeah, so we cast this, right? Oh, wait. Let's just attack first. Yeah, we cast for two. Does he actually have lethal on board just for himself? It's just 8, no 10. But if he's got the flying, buffing, or inspired. Alright, this is awesome, I've gotta admit. This is amazing. Mono white flyers. Let me actually check. Collection. So just white and just standard, please. Flying. Actually, you have Fairy Guide, Mario, you have Healer Sog, you have Loyal Pegasus. You have Concordia Pegasus, yeah. You have Graceful Apparition. Hushbringer. Rally of Wings, of course. Actually, it seems pretty good. Just do more mono white flyer stack. I mean, with one white flyers, you can also go like Venerated Loxodon and everything. Huh. Now, this seems interesting. And of course, in white, you have Sephara. Wow, I haven't thought about that. Okay, let's do... Yeah, we keep this. Got a lot of tokens that we can pump with Unbreakable Formation. Attack! Damn. Is there a counter spell? Thrill Mystic, alright. Okay, let's thin out our deck here. I wanna cast Rise the Alarm right now. So that it can be countered and then next turn we can go Unbreakable Formation probably. Awesome art. We block this. Nah. Okay, so this is some good value actually. I think we go ahead and attack the Nissa. Or do we? I mean, we got it down to 2. Or we can get 4 damage in. Uh, Like, my hope here is that our opponent's getting out of cards soon. Endure. But he's got 4 cards, we've got 2, so probably it is not an argument.
Harness the elements.
Oh, this is really good. This actually helps a lot. So we can get rid of the Nissa here. If he has no counter spell. Boring Nissa. No. Too bad. Attacks here.
Be wary of the ground you walk on.
It's just too much mana. Gotta say, it's too much mana. Smic Flash, huh? Ooh, new animation, I like it.
Nature's true power.
Now I'm actually gonna block with one, like, I'm going to block one with 2 1-1s and the other one with 1 2-2. So this way we keep a 2-2, which I like more. I wonder why he didn't attack with his lance. This is annoying. Like, arguably, I could also put in Failed Passages into the stack to thin out the stack even more. this is game. Let's concede here. Okay, we do one more game and then I think I'm gonna call it a day. And but as you can see, we just climbed some good ladder points with this deck. And I have no doubt that with this deck you can probably comfortably get to platinum very easily. Now, if we find the second land, this is pretty good. Or if our opponent concedes, you can also win. So, as I said, one last game. Keep this. Our opponent is going first. I think we can keep this with the finale to the finale so that we can Palmer Tongues. Okay. I think I attack here. Yeah. Our opponent being at 17 life already is actually very, or 15 life is very useful. It's a questing beast, okay. A prison realm would be nice. However, actually, for the time being, we're just going to tap his questing beast. Because if you play the Gideon here, let's just tap his questing beast. If you play the Gideon here, then it's gonna get destroyed by the questing beast, because questing beast, if it deals combat damage to us, it also deals that much damage to our planeswalker. Okay. I think we play the Stalwart. Play Stalwart and then tap his questing beast again, I guess. Yeah, let's tap his questing beast. Prison Realm, okay. So what can we do with Prison Realm? We can get... Castle play Giddy, or we can get 3 tokens with Finale of Glory. I think the best thing to do is... Wait. Get rid of the Lovestruck Beast. Tap the Questing Beast. And then block the Rotting Resort with the Sun of Stalwart, right? Yes, I want to raise the alarm. Stop at his main. No attacks, end the end turn. And now he's top decking. And so if I don't block his questing miss, we go down to 5. So I think it's actually better to block to tap the Regisaur and not block the questing miss, so we still have our Sun Home Stalwart. Okay. Probably the best thing to do here is to make 2 tokens. Right? And then we have 1 mana left for Dilaruun Enforcer. And what we're gonna do is we're going to tap the questing beast. And if he attacks with Rod and Regisaur, we just block with everything. Okay. Tap the questing beast because you can't block it. Maybe smart here, attacks. Oh yes, look at this. Can kill the Regisaur and actually get to kill the Sun of Stalwart because it has first strike. Or not. Now this is actually a nut straw. Stop his main. Oh, this is bad. Now, luckily he doesn't have any cards in hand. Now this is going to be an interesting moment. Yes. Yes. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Oh, this is so good. This is actually so good. I think we play Gideon, right? Play the Gideon. We give this vigilance.
I believe in you, friend.
Go in for 1 damage. And then we'll just tap his questing beast again. Please no creature. Ah! At least it's not a creature.
And I'm coming for you next. You picked the wrong fight.
Okay.
That was a good hit.
What I can actually do here, I can activate district, give it lifelink. Kill the Vivian, go in, and then I'm at 7 life. I think that's the play. I can't believe we're still in this game, but we are. Okay, let's go. Have lifelink.
Share my light.
Like this. I can actually kill my Ginyan, unfortunately. Ah. Your opponent got a land. So Gideon is dead here. It's not!
Do not frighten me.
Whoa! Damn it. If we had a land, would still have. We don't have a land. Damn it! Because the thing is, if I make tokens with the finale, they can block the questing beast, right? Oh, no. Oh. Cancel. Can't use unbreakable formation. I think we're just dead here. Because those are just 2/2s, right? Man, if we had one more mana. One more mana. That's all it would take. I mean, we can still survive a turn. Just attack here.
Will cleave the darkness.
Man, we got so lucky so far that our opponent didn't draw a single creature. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Well, we need to block with our district here. Funnily, our Gideon is still alive. Somehow. Man! What does it say? Power 2 less. So this doesn't help. Ah! Ah, unfortunately this got a good game, but okay. This was a nice last game. Trying to survive, but in the end we just didn't get that next land that would have turned around anything. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed it and look forward to more videos to come, especially next week when Xeras Beyond Death is going to be released. really excited about that, and I see you guys on that video.